What do you get if you cross one of your favourite hi-fi speakers with a diamond? Tweeter. Not a Bowers & Wilkins. This is my review of the Marten Parker Duo Diamond Edition Stand Mount Hi-Fi speakers. And it's a review I've been really looking forward to because back in March, I reviewed and looked at Marten's Parker Duo speakers, the ceramic version, and I was massively actually impressed with them. And you would think, you know, the Diamond Edition, an upgraded version of the speaker would be exactly that. But is it or isn't it? The Parker Duo are a two-way stand mount speaker featuring a 7.5-inch ceramic mid-bass driver that is front firing, and on the rear a 9-inch aluminium passive radiator. And this is accompanied by, in theory, the star of the show, a 1-inch diamond tweeter that has the same concave profile as the ceramic tweeter in the ceramic version of the speaker. And it's also as equally difficult to get that tweeter on camera because of the grille that sits in front of it. And these are pretty large stand mount speakers, and they are heavy, with a uniquely shaped cabinet that is made from M-board, a Marten proprietary material. On the inside is another major difference with the crossover, which is a multi-diverse order design, crossing over at 2.2 kHz, and Marten are using copper foil capacitors in the diamond edition of the speaker instead of polypropylene capacitors that are used with the ceramic edition. All the other specifications are the same, so 200 watts rating, 88 decibels sensitivity, but another difference are with the speaker cable binding posts. Marten are using a higher quality connector from WBT with the Diamond Edition. And as far as I could tell, those are the three main differences. So obviously the diamond tweeter, the copper foil capacitors on the crossover, and the speaker cable binding posts. But how does that affect the price? For this Piano Black Diamond Edition, they will set you back £17,500 compared to £9,500 for the Piano Black Ceramic Edition. So that is a big price increase for the diamonds, and it really pushes the competition from, say, KEF Reference 3 or maybe Bowers 804D4 up to maybe KEF Blade kind of level in terms of price, or maybe Bowers 803 or maybe the 2D4. Either way, it's some, you know, create some crazy stiff competition for a speaker like this. And I hope you noticed that I use floor standing speakers there as the examples, because obviously that is what you can buy at this kind of price point. So that is even stiffer competition in ways when you think about it. And I also think they're apt competitors because you can place the Parker Duos in your room, maybe in a smaller to medium sized room, and still get floor stander like performance out of them in terms of bass and in terms of scale. So when you're trying to weigh up all these decisions, it definitely doesn't make it easy. Especially when we have to talk about the speaker stands, because I can assure you, you will want to use the dedicated stands for the Parker Duo speakers, because they put them at exactly the right height, and I think a slight angle, and they secure the speakers to the stands, so there couldn't be any accidental topples of your £17,500 investment. And the stands are a fair chunk of money, priced at £2,450. But remember, a big part of that price is going to the co-designed isoacoustics speaker stand isolators. And I made sure I tested the stands as part of the review, because I started with the Duo Diamonds on my Atacama Nexus speaker stands, which are pretty much the same height, but only cost about one-tenth, about £200. So one-tenth of what the Marten stands do. And of course, the Duo Diamonds still sounded good on those stands, but they definitely didn't sound like the Parker Duo speakers that I remember. And in fact, it wasn't until I put them on the dedicated stands did their sound really open up, did their kind of tonal balance shift a little bit, I think, as well. And it really was a noticeable step up, it really was a noticeable difference. And again, these speakers definitely sound best on their dedicated stands. And throughout this early listening, it definitely hit home to me that the Parker Duo Diamonds, they are a different speaker actually, quite a different sounding speaker to the Parker Duo Ceramics, which is really interesting. And the reason I say that is because what I really liked about the Parker Duo Ceramic version was their big, bold, warm, quite rich tonal character that I had to then balance with a very lively sounding amplifier. And it did balance really fantastic. But interestingly, with the Parker Duo Diamonds, they started out, they already sounded more lively, more upfront, more dynamic, more highly resolving. And this was really reaffirmed to me when I measured the Duo diamonds as part of a full Dirac Live calibration and then compared the measurements to the Parker Duo ceramic. What is interesting, as you can see, the Parker Duo ceramic measured more recessed in their upper mid-range and more recessed in their treble, whereas the Duo Diamond measured more neutral in that upper mid-range and more neutral in the treble, with a slight rise in the treble. Only slight, but I think this slight rise is definitely important for how they sound, despite only being very slight. But do remember, these measurements were taken in my room on different days with different speaker placement and slightly different room acoustics. However, I think based on what I was hearing and how I remember the Duo Ceramic sounding, and then these measurements, I think it is all a good indicator of the sonic differences, or some of the sonic differences anyway, between the two versions of the speaker. Also very worthy of note, as you can see, or maybe not see, there is no crossover dip, which shows that Marten have done an excellent job with the crossover in terms of frequency. So with all of that technical information out of the way, what do the Marten Parker Duo Diamond Edition speakers actually sound like? Well, not like other Marten speakers that I've listened to before. Marten speakers have always impressed me with their kind of rich and bold and warm, tonally saturated sound. And I've always liked them and admired their speakers for that. But sometimes, you know, you have to be a little bit careful because sometimes that type of sound can become too much of a good thing. But the Duo Diamond definitely don't suffer that issue. They sound fast and crisp and lively. They sound more like a high resolution speaker that is opening the window onto the music and allowing you to see very much into it. Their overall sound presentation is less warm and cuddly and more open and resolving. So transients, especially higher frequency transients, are crisp sounding and there is more overall space in the sound stage. Treble details I found to be crisp and quite attacking, with more authenticity to say cymbals rather than them being presented deliberately pleasing. But please don't confuse that last comment as maybe a convoluted way of maybe saying that these speakers are bright or harsh or anything like that. Definitely not. All I mean is when there's maybe attacking higher frequencies or attacking cymbals, for example, in music, well, then they are attacking from the Parker Duo Diamonds, but definitely not attacking all the time. Although I definitely was aware of the treble, I definitely was more aware of the treble from these, from the Parker Duo Diamonds, than I have been from, you know, other speakers that I've had in to review. Vocals, they definitely were presented with that Marten speaker tonality that I definitely was looking for. And I feel like, you know, vocals and just general tonality could be one of the reasons why you would choose or buy a Marten speaker in the first place. And with the Parker Duo Diamonds, I was really impressed by the fact that, you know, male vocals sounded male and sometimes big and full and gruff, all the way up to almost glass shattering female vocals in opera and pretty much everything in between. Vocals really pop. They really pop off of the background because they sit, you know, in more of an open type of soundstage with a nice amount of space around them, which allows, it always allows vocals to really pop off of the background. I was very impressed with the soundstage depth and I really enjoyed how they managed to balance a sound that could go away from you at times with a sound in other music that either could come out towards you or just feel very close and very intimate. And I'll see that as them being a very transparent speaker, you know, transparent to the music, but they are also a, you know, an audiophile or a hi-fi transparent speaker. You don't hear sounds from the speakers, you hear it from everywhere else, but I also take that as a given from any speaker around this kind of price point. Lastly, we need to talk about bass, because I was massively impressed with the Parker Duo Ceramic Editions for their bass, for being big, bold and powerful. I had them set up to deliver very much a floor standing like speaker amount of bass with excellent definition. Interestingly, the Duo Diamonds seemed a little more polite in their bass, favouring even more control and even more definition. So I found myself liking the Duo Diamonds bass for a very different reason. But I feel, you know, this is probably also me pulling the speakers out into the room more, and definitely the amplifier that was using, the German Physics Emperor Extreme amplifier. When it comes to bass, it has got an insane amount of control, you know, ridiculous amount of control actually when it comes to driving speakers and control on the bass. And the bass is very tight, very articulate. But what about comparisons? And this is where things get really interesting, because I've just reviewed the German Physics HRS-130 with the exact same amplifier and setup. And yes, they are floor standing speakers, but they are two-way and priced at £18,800 for the pair I have here. So really, they are direct competition. And for those of you who might not have watched the HRS-130 review, I suggest you do, because I feel like this comparison will make a lot more sense. But the HRS-130 do soundstage incredibly well. And they also feature a proprietary driver that creates pretty much all of their mid-range and treble. So their cohesion of sound is really incredible. And despite how great the job Marten have done with the crossover of the duo diamonds, the German Physics do sound more cohesive in the mid-range because they don't have a crossover in the vocal region. And the HRS-130 also create a soundstage with even more depth and clearer layering. However, where the duo diamonds shine is their musical intensity. Music punches through more and has more attack, especially in the higher frequencies. There is just more bite to the sound. Vocals, while not quite as cohesive, can sound a little more full-bodied, especially for deeper male vocals. And bass, I feel, is a little more punchy from the Martens and maybe a little more smooth extended from the German Physics. Placement in the room seems less critical with the Martens, so it might be easier to get better bass response from them because you can use them closer to the walls. And maybe they are a little more music genre agnostic because they have more bite to their sound, which could be great for rock and maybe heavier types of music. And I can confidently say that I loved listening to both speakers, actually. Both of them stood out to me with their own individual kind of strengths and characters. And, you know, I really enjoyed and could happily live with either speaker. I possibly would say that the Parker Duo Diamonds possibly suit my room a little better because they are a little bit easier to place closer to walls, which is, you know, gives me some boundary reinforcement, gets me slightly better bass at my listening position. But I definitely feel like adding a good subwoofer or two actually to both speakers could have been really beneficial for that, you know, extra bit of, you know, specialness that you get from adding really good subwoofers to pretty much every pair of hi-fi speakers. I'm going to finish by looking at who are the Marten Parker Duo Diamonds actually for. Well, I feel like the obvious first customer could be current Parker Duo ceramic speaker owners, because you can upgrade them. And obviously it's a chunk of money to upgrade them, but you do get a better speaker, a higher resolution speaker. However, if you start with the Parker Duo Diamonds, I think your amplifier choices are likely going to be a lot wider than with the ceramics. And I think that will help you find that right sound synergy for you. And obviously, some audiophiles might prefer the more relaxed, more laid back, the warmer sounding Parker Duo ceramics. So as always, test both speakers out and see which one you prefer. But when you are demoing the speakers, again, make sure you use the dedicated stands because it does make a big difference. And that is what you're getting here, really, with the Marten Parker Duo Diamond Edition. You are getting, you know, a very, very capable stand mount speaker that performs bigger. You know, the sound it creates is bigger than its physical size, although it's still quite a large speaker. But it's the extra quality, it's the extra resolution, it's that extra, you know, standout character of performance that you are really paying for here. That's where the extra money is really going. And obviously, whether the money's justified for the difference, that'd be up to you. And obviously, have a listen for yourself. I feel like if you can afford it, you're probably going to enjoy listening to these more because they, again, they open that window up just that bit wider. So I hope you've enjoyed this review. I hope you found it useful and helpful. If you enjoyed it, make sure you give it the obligatory thumbs up and subscribe to the Pursuit of Perfect System YouTube channel. If you haven't already, of course you have. Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you soon. Take care.